years.
Around Myrtle Beach, toward Myrtle Beach, and at that one, for more than 2 weeks.
Yeah, we're going to check down.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection, and I am life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet they shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you also shall live. Friends, we have gathered here to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Richard Heisey. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace that in pain we might find comfort, in sorrow hope, and in death resurrection. Let us pray. O God who gave us birth, you are ever more ready to hear than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask, and our ignorance in asking. Give to us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and of death. Help us to live as those who are prepared to die, and when our days here are accomplished, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that living or dying, our life may be in you, and that nothing in life or in death will be able to separate us from your great love in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Our first scriptural lesson for this service is Psalm 130. Out of the depths I cry unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my cry. Let thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. If thou, Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou may be feared. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits, and in his word do I hold. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord is great mercy. With him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all their sins. Our second scripture lesson is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verses 28 through 31. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is an everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not be faint. A reading. Weep not for me. Weep not for me, though I have gone into that gentle night. Grieve if you will, but not for long. Upon my soul's sweet flight, I am at peace, my soul's at rest. There is no need for tears, for with your love I was so blessed for all those many years. There is no pain, I suffer not. The fear is now gone. Put these things out of your thoughts. In your memory, I will live on. Remember not my fight for breath. Remember not the strife. Please do not dwell upon my path, but celebrate my life. We're going to enter a time of sharing of stories and remembrances, and I have some provided by the family that they would like me to read. Richard is the oldest of five children, the only boy, the big brother to four sisters, Diana, Carol, Wendy, and Sheila. He is uncle to Don, great uncle to Brandon and Dylan. Like any brother, he occasionally terrorized his sisters, but as adults, he enjoyed when they were together, reminiscing, telling stories of the past, and sharing laughs. He was proud of his sisters. He loved peanut butter cups and Molson Golden beer, hunting and fishing, and watching deer at his deer feeder from the back of his bag. He preferred rock and roll as his musical genre, his favorite being Iron Butterfly. He was quite the storyteller. He loved to share stories about seeing a bear walk up to the cabin when at camp, or his most recent encounter with a snake at the cabin. He loved cooking on the grill for others. He was a good cook, but he didn't like doing the cleanup. He made the best steam shrimp. When microwave ovens first came out, his mother declared that there was finally something that could cook food quicker than he could eat it. His brother-in-law, Michael, and he went to Punxsutawney 2 years ago for Groundhog Day, but the weather turned to ice and they couldn't drive into town for the celebration, but they had a great weekend in the camper and more stories to tell when they returned. He was a hard worker and was always helping someone out. When they lost heat in the winter, or needed an air conditioning system installed, or found themselves with broken water pipes. He was proud to share that he did most of the work restoring his sister's house after the 2011 flood reached 6 feet into her townhouse. The family would now like to invite you all if you'd like to share a story or offer a witness or a testimony to Richard's life. You can come up here, or you can stand where you're at. Our gospel lesson for this service comes from the Gospel of John. select verses from chapter 14. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live." I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, with whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. The second reading, Life Goes On, by Joyce Renfield. If I should go before the rest of you, break not a flower, nor inscribe a stone, nor when I am gone, speak in a Sunday voice, but be the usual selves that I have known. Weep if you must, pardon is hell, but life goes on, so sing as well. And our final scripture lesson comes from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us pray. God of us all, your love never ends. When all else fails, you are still God. We pray to you for one another in our need, and for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who have sinned, mercy. To all who sorrow, your peace. Keep true in us the love with which we hold one another. In all our ways we trust you. And to you, with your church, on earth and in heaven, we offer honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And let me offer this blessing as we go forth. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace.